Edgar Allan Poe regards sleep as little slices of death. John Steinbeck wrote in The Grapes of Wrath, Death was a friend and sleep was death's brother. And in Greek mythology, the god of death Thanatos and the god of sleep Hypnos were twins. But as Mahatma Gandhi said, each night when I go to sleep I die, and the next morning when I wake up I am reborn. So, writers and philosophers have been trying to refine the definition of sleep for a long time, and it's still a difficult task even today. Scientists in different disciplines define sleep in their own ways, characteristic to their field of study. Behaviorists define sleep as a reversible and unconscious state in which 1% lack of mobility, reduced response to external stimulation, impaired cognition, and elevated arousal threshold. Scientists that study metabolism of living creatures describe sleep as an anabolic state in which nutrients are more likely to be stocked than used. Finally, physicians define sleep as a state of decreased brain, eye, and muscle activity and give us the most complete understanding of sleep using EEG, EOG, and EMG technologies. It's been some time since we got these technologies, but we have only recently started to use them to learn more about activities of our muscles, brain, and eyes during sleep. Electroencephalography, also mercifully known as EEG, tracks brain electrical activity, which tremendously helps scientists to define the structure of our sleep. Electromyography, or EMG, tracks muscle electrical activity, which is increased during wakefulness and decreased during sleep. Lastly, electrooculography, or EOG, tracks electrical activity of our eyes, further breaking down sleep into REM and NREM. So, what we have learned about sleep using these technologies? Coming up! Hi, Andre here, welcome to the Practical Health Channel. As your intuition might already have told you, there is nothing simple about the process of sleep. But let's summarize what science knows about sleep today. And we'll start with the concept of sleep architecture. Some might think about pillow and blanket force, but it's different, much more exciting. As humans, we have three states of consciousness: awake state, non-rapid eye movement state of sleep, known as NREM sleep, and rapid eye movement state of sleep, known as REM sleep. NREM sleep can be further broken down into three substates by some scientists and into four substates by others: N1, or sometimes called NREM1, N2, N3, and N4. The latest consensus reached by the American Academy of Sleep Medicine in 2007 is to combine N3 and N4 together. Combined, they're now called N3, or slow wave sleep, or deep sleep. So there's a lot of complex science and interesting terminology to explain why you sometimes drool on your pillow. What characterizes each state? The awake state is defined as active electrical activity of brain, muscles, and eyes. It's quite logical. Everything is active when we are in the awake state. Okay, get up and move around state. Then the NREM sleep phase begins to progressively slow down activities in the brain, eyes, and muscles from N1 to N3. N1 is regarded as shallow sleep. A person may be easily woken up from shallow sleep by just calling their name or by simple environmental noise. While in N1, you are still aware of your surroundings. If woken up during N1, you may not even feel like you slept at all. N1 and N2 stages together called the light sleep. You've probably heard about this term. The N3 stage has the lowest level of electrical activity, so it's called deep sleep. Finally, REM sleep, in which we dream, is quite different from NREM sleep. During REM sleep, both eyes and the brain present intense activity, while the body has close to none. It's like a mullet hairstyle, business in the front and party in the back, boring, nothing less in the body, and the party in the brain and eyes. Overall, we tend to sleep by going repeatedly through these phases, from N1 to N2 to N3 to REM, and then back to N1 and so on. A sleep cycle is defined as one passage from N1 to REM and takes about 90 to 110 minutes. Graphically, our sleep cycle looks like the skyline of a city with peaks and valleys, just like you would view Los Angeles from the hills. Scientists have found that 5 cycles of NREM-REM sleep are the best for our long-term health. Guess what? This is exactly the ever-so-recommended 7.5 to 8 hours of sleep. N1 stage is the shortest one. It accounts for only 3-8% of the total sleep. N2, the largest one. It accounts for about 45-55%. N3, deep sleep, 15-23%. Finally, the REM sleep makes up 20-25% of our total sleep. If we talk specifically about brain activities in the awake state, we see alpha rhythms in some parts of the brain, while in other parts of the brain we see very fast beta rhythms. This stage is called stage W and associated with waking eye movements, horizontal, oblique, vertical, both slow and fast eye movements. Basically, our brain is active and our muscles and eyes are active. We didn't need a scientist to figure it out, right? So, as we go to sleep, we slowly dive into the N1 phase, called shallow or active sleep. In this state, we may feel that we miss a step or have a sudden jerk of movement that immediately wakes us up. It's like that feeling when you lean too far back in your chair and almost tip over, but catch yourself just at the last second, but with sleep. Brain activity starts to slow down so that alpha waves diminish by 50% and intermix with slower beta waves and theta rhythms. Sounds like a sci-fi movie, right? The end of N1 is marked by sharp vertex waves, a transition point to N2. The N2 begins about 10 minutes after falling asleep, just as N1 ends, and is characterized by K complexes and spindles, fast spindles and slow spindles depending on the brain areas. K complexes are a waveform comprised of two components, a negative wave followed by a positive wave, lasting for more than half a second each. Spindles are a EEG projection of GABA neurotransmitter, releasing clusters of thalamic inhibiting neurons. They fire up as a pacemaker, just like our heart sending electrical impulses to the myocardium, which tell it to pump in a certain rhythm. By the way, don't confuse GABA and ABA, they are different. Basically, our brain rhythmically slows down even more from N1, like a baby when it hears its mother's lullaby. In this N2 stage, our heart rate goes down, our breathing slows down, and our blood pressure drops. The body metabolism gradually slows, and since we burn less fuel, our body temperature drops too. This is another stage of slowing down of the brain, representing the transition point toward a more profound sleep, N3 stage. The N3 or deep sleep is when the body enters an anabolic state of muscle building, immune system strengthening, and tissue repairing mode by increasing blood flow to damaged parts of our body. In this state, the brain waves, known as delta waves, are the slowest. The body further decreases its metabolism, blood pressure, heart rate, and breathing rate from N2. In addition, the glial cells are activated to clear debris from the brain, such as beta amyloid, the dementia protein. We can say N3 is the most healing stage of our sleep cycles. This stage is regarded as a deep sleep due to the slow wave activities of the brain, with little to no eye movement and decreased muscle tone. In this stage, it's the most difficult to wake one up, requiring over 100 decibels of noise to do so. That may be either a high-volume rock song or a handheld drill making holes in your head. Also, if woken up from this stage, one may feel terribly tired. This is known as a mental fogginess or sleep inertia. Cognitive tests reveal an impairment for 30 to 60 minutes after waking up from this stage of sleep. So if you have one of those mornings, it might be due to waking up directly from N3. A sleeping gadget or a sleeping app might help you avoid that. Finally, we go into REM sleep. The electrical brain activity presents slow alpha waves, almost the same as during wakefulness, combined with the slow theta. This stage can be further broken down into tonic REM and phasic REM. Tonic REM is characterized by lack of tonus in the skeletal muscles, desynchronized brain activity, and suppression of reflexes. The phasic REM is characterized by rapid eye movement in all directions, irregular breathing, changes in the heart rate and blood pressure, as well as muscle jerking of the tongue, limbs, and chin. That explains why in my dreamy sleep I flail around like an electrocuted octopus. Overall, REM sleep is characterized by our dreaming, increased body temperature, and higher levels of acetylcholine, a neurotransmitter that activates the brain. REM sleep has been shown to be a great regulator for our psychological side. A lack of REM sleep has been proven to generate anxiety, mood swings, hallucinations, and difficulty concentrating. It's a state when the brain can process emotions and memories in a stress-free environment. While N3 deep sleep is longer during the first period of night, REM sleep is longer during the last third of the night. REM sleep of the first night sleep cycle lasts for roughly 10 minutes, but by the end of the night can last up to an hour. You may have noted that it's more frequent you wake up directly from your dream in the morning, since the brain is already active. It's similar to the state of wakefulness. Scientists have demonstrated that it's best to wake up during REM stage. You may regret being pulled out of your sweet dreams, but at least you won't wake up with unpleasant sleep inertia. Instead, you'll be invigorated with the already activated brain, ready for a new day. So that's it for today. I hope you learned something new from this video. Let's sum up what we discussed today. A sleep cycle consists of a sequential time lapse of N1, N2, N3 and REM stages, and lasts for 90 to 110 minutes. The recommended time to sleep per night is made of 5 sleeping cycles, meaning 7.5 to 8 hours. Each stage has its own benefits to our well-being. If you wake up from N3, deep sleep, you might feel foggy and slow, so you have to give yourself 30 to 60 minutes to be fully operational. And finally, the REM stage is when we dream and have the fast brain electrical activity. This is the best stage to wake up from. The research master for this episode is Dr. Florin Horian. Florin is a European microsurgeon who is super passionate not only about his practice, but also about the exciting science behind a healthy lifestyle. And our visualization partner is Beam Motion Studio. Next time, we'll talk about why exactly we need sleep. Why sleep is so critical for our brain and body. See you next time. Bye.